vector-borne diseases are infectious diseases that usually don't transmit from an individual to an individual directly, but they need to go through an additional organism that we call a vector.
So there are, for example, mosquitoes, ticks, large variety of ticks, also midges, which are very small and can go through mosquito net, for example, they can pass through. And you have also sandflies.
Vector-borne diseases are an important cause of illness in the world today. Malaria, spread by mosquitoes, infects over 200 million people every year, causing over 600,000 deaths. Dengue fever, another mosquito-borne disease, infects 390 million people, while 3 billion people are at risk from Japanese encephalitis. These diseases are most prevalent in the tropical regions of the world, but climate change and globalization have contributed to the spread of the diseases and their carriers to more temperate zones like Europe.
We are undergoing a serious change in our climate, and species that were previously considered exotic species are now able to enter our territory and survive, establish themselves. The rate of introduction has been increased by the movement of people, movement of goods that have increased our connection to the outside world.
Diseases that were largely unknown in Europe are now appearing throughout the continent. The European Food Safety Authority monitors vectors and vector-borne diseases and analyzes their spread in the European Union. This can help reduce the risk of epidemics.
Schmallenberg is an excellent example. The disease appeared in Europe as a new disease, but we very quickly realized that the vector species was a species that we knew from before, and we've been able to use mathematical models that we had for blue tongue to forecast the progression of the disease across Europe, and the forecast was very accurate.
The European Food Safety Authority and the European Centre for Disease Prevention and Control are jointly coordinating the collection of data and information on vector-borne diseases. The project, which will set up a database, is called VectorNet and aims to reduce the risk to European citizens and animals from these debilitating illnesses.
There is actual work going on between ECDC and EFSA, which is joining forces to map these vectors in Europe and surrounding countries, because these vectors don't have any border.
The idea of this database is to collect information, data on the presence, distribution, and also abundance of those vectors or potential vectors. And this is based on a network of expertise across Europe involving all sorts of institutions and research bodies.
EFSA and ECDC working together to make Europe safer.